Welcome! In today's video, we will look at what options the Odroid H3 Plus has for expansion. This is another Odroid H3 Plus. I've mounted this one in a small MakerBeam frame for ease of handling. First of all, we'll have a look around the Odroid itself. We have the CPU which dominates the small motherboard, which has a large aluminium heatsink sitting on top of the processor. You do not need to fit this yourself as it comes pre-fitted from the factory. On the front of our board, we have the two Ethernet ports, both of these rated at 2.5 gigabits. We have four USB ports, two USB 3s and two USB 2s. We have an HDMI port and a display port, plus our audio ports. On the motherboard itself, we have two SATA ports with SATA power connectors. So this board can support two external disk drives. Additionally, on the base of our board, we have slots for two SODIMM memory cards, and we also have an NVMe M.2 slot. On one of my other Odroids, I've actually fitted a 1TB SSD. However, as you will see from the board, there is no PCIe expansion slot. So the ability to add a graphics card to this board does not appear to exist. Also on our motherboard is of a small, almost invisible connector for fitting an eMMC memory board. And that's what we have here. This is a 64 gigabit memory card. We can fit this onto the motherboard, and this can be used to boot up from. And that is our memory card fitted into place. We can now boot up this Odroid using this as our boot drive. You can purchase these either blank from Odroid or with a Linux distro on them. So how can we further expand this Odroid board? One thing we can do is to make use of the M.2 slot on the base of the motherboard. Ever since the Odroid H2, you have been able to buy an expansion board which fits in here on the M.2 slot that gives you an additional four Ethernet ports, which appear underneath the board itself. However, an additional option is to make use of one of your high-speed USB ports. And that would be to allow us to use one of these. This is a USB 3 to hard disk connector. So you can either connect a SATA SSD or a traditional spinning hard disk. However, fitting one of these to the front of the board does leave the cable sticking out. However, there are some small USB connectors which will fit in quite nicely. These 180-degree USB connectors can quite happily fit into the front of our board, like so. And this keeps the cable clutter away from the front of the board, allowing you to connect your USB cable underneath the main board and out of sight of the user. And this SATA power and data cable can then fit into another hard disk or SSD fitted to the side or behind the main board. So you can quite easily have two SATA disks connected to the motherboard and a third one connected to this cable. Another option I will be exploring is to fit a card into this M.2 slot, which would give us a full PCIe expansion slot, into which we could fit a graphics card. I have looked at sitting a card in here that would give us an expansion of four additional SATA ports. However, investigations look as though this will not currently work with the Odroid as it stands at the moment. So these are a few of the options I will be exploring in the coming weeks for the Odroid H3 Plus. But that's it for today. Thank you for watching.